Dad, what's wrong with the telly?
Good evening, London. Allow me first to apologize for this
emergency channel.
I do, like many of you, appreciate the comforts of the everyday routine, the security of the familiar, the tranquility, repetition.
Bloody hell.
I enjoy them as much as any bloke. But in the spirit of commemoration, whereby those important events of the past, usually associated with someone's death or the end of some awful bloody struggle, are celebrated with a nice holiday, I thought we could mark this November the 5th, a day that is sadly no longer remembered, by taking some time out of our daily lives to sit down and have a little chat. There are, of course, those who do not want us to speak.
Let me think, just let me think.
I suspect even now orders are being shouted into telephones and men with guns will soon be on their way.
It's Chancellor.
Damn it!
Why? Because while the truncheon may be used in lieu of conversation, words will always retain their power. Words offer the means to meaning, and for those who will listen, the enunciation of truth. And the truth is, there is something terribly wrong with this country, isn't there?
You designed it, sir. You wanted it foolproof. You told me every television in London.
Cruelty and injustice, intolerance and oppression. And where once you had the freedom to object, to think and speak as you saw fit, you now have sensors and systems of surveillance coercing your conformity and soliciting your submission.
We need cameras.
How did this happen? Who's to blame? Well, certainly there are those who are more responsible than others, and they will be held accountable. But again, truth be told, if you're looking for the guilty, you need only look into a mirror. I know why you did it. I know you were afraid. Who wouldn't be? War, terror, disease. There were a myriad of problems which conspired to... Fear got the best of you, and in your panic you turned to the now High Chancellor, Adam Sutler. He promised you order, he promised you peace, and all he demanded in return was your silent, obedient consent.
Inspector, you're almost through.
Last night, I sought to end that silence. Last night, I destroyed the Old Bailey to remind this country of what it has forgotten.
More than 400 years ago, a great citizen wished to embed the 5th of November forever in our memory. His hope was to remind the world that fairness, justice, and freedom are more than words. They are perspectives. So if you've seen nothing, if the crimes of this government remain unknown to you, then I would suggest that you allow the 5th of November to pass unmarked. But if you see what I see, if you feel as I feel, and if you would seek as I seek, then I ask you to stand beside me 1 year from tonight, outside the gates of Parliament, and together we shall give them a 5th of November that shall never, ever be forgotten.
Kerosene fog. He's using our smoke machines.
Cover the exits. No one gets out.
The rest of you follow me.